In our last session, we learned primary time-based SQL injection WAF bypasses. This time, we will move one step further and try to beat WAF rules for other SQL injection types. Let's review other ways in which some defenses could be implemented and how to bypass them. Let's start directly from the defensive side with already prepared firewall rule. Depending on the target, if it's security hardened or not, there could be advanced defenses in place. It really depends on how seriously the security team of the program adds extra layer of protection. I have seen some of you asking questions about creating a setup like this, just to try practicing firewall bypasses yourself. I have made behind the scenes video for that. You can find it for free on my Patreon. But some paid patrons could get some extra perks like getting username mentioned, access to certain channels on Discord, getting videos 1 week in advance, recon data and live hacking recordings, and many more useful stuff depending on the subscription level. Like previously, I have already shown some basics that could be bypassed. It will be much harder to bypass defenses right now, but it's not impossible. Let's explore this example. It will convert a URL query to lowercase and checked for two blacklisted words, AND and OR. When we initially approach the target, we won't know what firewall rule will be present. We can get some presumptions after getting indications from tools like Gauri or sqlmap, or by testing manually, of course. So, if you get blocked by a web application firewall initially, you want to check which words could be filtered out. It's pretty similar to bypassing XSS, where you want to check which HTML tags are being filtered out. This time, you want to check which known SQL commands are being filtered out. From the black box testing perspective, we can see that AND and OR strings are being filtered out, but not their logical symbols. I have seen some of you suggesting to use the Atlas tool for sqlmap tamper detection, even though it was updated 4 years ago. It is still a valid option. Personally, I do not use it that much, since it could truly create a lot of false positives and it will be wasting my time. But let's see it in action and I will let you decide yourself. Before running Atlas for tamper suggestions, you will need to get initial payload for SQL injection. You can construct it yourself or you can use sqlmap. The sqlmap has a verbosity option. To see payloads, you will need to set verbosity to at least 3. There are verbosity levels up to 5, but those will give a lot of the information that we don't need. So let's run like this. Okay, we have started seeing some payloads, so I will cancel. So we need to copy one of those and try to paste it for Atlas in the payload flag right here. As you can see, it gave us a lot of results, although it's still useful because I know one of them should work, but you will still be spending a lot of time checking each of those tampers. If you know another tool that could do the job, just let me know down in the comments. There is much better way that I personally use, so let me show you. I have another tab prepared just for showing all sqlmap tampers. Let's list them out. There is much to choose from, but if you remember, we need to replace AND and OR strings with logic operators. What I like to do is, in this case, is to use grep command for filtering. We can use E flag to use regular expressions and use uppercase letters, just because those tamper scripts likes using uppercase right here. And we can see there is only two of them left out instead of choosing all of those. So this one will work the best. Let's use this one for sqlmap. And as you can see, it found out and it worked pretty nice. We could play around the whole day by doing this, just checking the block strings and trying to find ways how to bypass them. But in the real world scenarios, there could be other very simple blocks implemented, like here. It will check how many requests are going from the same IP to our specified endpoint. In this case, if that endpoint receives 10 requests per 10 seconds, your IP will be blocked for some time. It could get blocked indefinitely, like right here. So in that case, if you remember from the last videos, I do recommend using NordVPN and just switching your IP. This is the VPN that I personally use. It's very good and I do recommend it. You can get discount if you use my link in the description. But if you don't want to get blocked in the first place, I suggest using delay option. So if we check like this one, it will be more gentle on the website because you can like specify how many seconds between each request to send. Of course, your SQL map will be much, much slower, but in this case, your IP will be good to go. Thank you very much for watching. It was my pleasure to share two more extra tips on this topic. Maybe next time we will check how to bypass some status codes like 401 or 403. And as always, I wish you earn pretty good bounties.